Actually, I did my views, but now liberal measures. Some such attendant politics, like progressive politics, like me, I'm not Nigerian. Well, actually, as a liberal commentator, human rights activist, I want to pay attention to the problem of, well, actually, narcotics and narcomafia in the city of Los Angeles. As you know, city of Los Angeles has issued ordinances number 181530, the so-called temporary urgency order, in which police has been prohibited to close down medical marijuana dispensaries, and medical marijuana dispensaries are supposed to register themselves to be taxed, you know. And they actually, this legislation, City Ordinance 181530, it's a very cynical one, which violates Federal Controlled Substance Act, you know, directly and very blatantly, you know, in which, because it's actually, legalizes illegal marijuana sales of illegal marijuana, narcotic marijuana, and actually prohibit police to close down medical marijuana, so-called medical marijuana dispensaries. And I believe the city of Los Angeles actually made a very bad choice, in which it actually didn't follow its mantra of being haven for dope dealers. You know, obviously, such Lancaster City prohibited sales of marijuana, and doctors who prescribe marijuana as a medication have been prosecuted rightfully for, you know, for authorizing illegal narcotic sales, for violating those substance acts. I know, while traveling, in the city of Los Angeles, I found so-called doctor's offices, the doctors were specialized in issuing medical marijuana receipts medical marijuana prescriptions, the so-called doctors, because those doctors violate Controlled Substance Act, and illegally prescribe substance abuse. Substance abuse is not medication, it's not treatment of patients, you know. Substance abuse is a crime, you know. And actually, authorizing substance abuse is a criminal act. And one of those so-called doctors was situated at 1439 Highland Avenue in West Hollywood, California. And unfortunately, federal agents like Drug Enforcement Agency, personnel, they actually too corrupt to close down what medical marijuana dispensaries, especially once it's in the in Hollywood area of California, Los Angeles, California, in 1607 North El Centro Avenue, where actually which charges most kind of money to substance abusers. They charge about $200 per 1 ounce of dope, you know. And it's outrageous, the city of Los Angeles, you know, doesn't close them down, you know. This, for instance, this one, 607 North Central Avenue, called Hollywood Dispensary. It sells dope to substance abusers and charges egregious sums of money for 1 ounce of illegal dope. They charge about $200 for 1 ounce of dope, and they ruin substance abusers. And those people are just vicious criminals who sell illegal dope, you know. And I would show police officers in law enforcement stages to close down this medical marijuana dispensary because this is heaven for illegal substance abuse. And this has happened in the city of Los Angeles under the rule of Mayor Antonio Villaraigosa, who actually doesn't pave any potholes, and potholes in the South Central remain still unpaved, you know. Like potholes on Jefferson Boulevard and Catalina Avenue and Crenshaw Boulevard near Coliseum Avenue. They remain unfixed, you know, because the government led by Mayor Antonio Villaraigosa spent money on such a vagaries like gross wages of council members and mayor's wage of $178,000, you know, instead of spending money on fixing potholes. So we see don't have money to fix potholes, but you don't have money to waste it on egregious wages of those parasites and bloodsuckers like the city council members who pocket $178,000. Of gross annual income, you know, while poor city workers, you know, can't have enough money to pay them, you know, rent, you know, and we don't have money to buy any art whatsoever. We didn't buy my art either, where I painted very beautiful neo-realistic paintings, and like those ones. When I offered them to city council member, they refused to buy those. My beautiful painting. I have about 17 paintings in all acrylic, and nobody was so far bought them, you know. And I offer them to the American public. You can call my cellular number 2134400093 or my home phone number 323-735-3863 to buy my beautiful paintings. Portraits and landscapes in oil and acrylic on canvas, say like 49 by 49 inch or 24 inch by 18 inch. It's actually my gallery was one of the best in the world, you know, and actually I wrote portraits of how the U.S. House Representative Nancy Pelosi and portraits of Charles Ranger, of Hillary Clinton as well, her portraits of Hillary Clinton, and portraits of Hillary Clinton. So that they were not interested in buying any paintings, but they were not interested in paving any street walls, city council members. They were interested in ripping off the public what bloodsuckers such as Rosenthal, Peretz, and Bernard Park, who didn't raise taxes against oil producing corporations, but want to live like lords in the city of Los Angeles, lords, you know. Who actually don't even have money, well, city don't have money to sweep the streets, like Spring Street near, in downtown Spring Street, near the intersection of Arcadia and Cesar Chavez Street, is not being swept, and tons of garbage, being laid, you know, on the top of those sidewalks, you know. So tons of garbage, you know, litter the sidewalks of Spring Street, you know, in downtown Los Angeles, near Colosseum, near Arcadia Street and City Chavez Avenue. And nobody cares to, you know, to remove the garbage of those streets, and homeless people, you know, line up those sidewalks of Spring Street near City Chavez and Colosseum Avenue, like those. And they steal those shopping carts. And police does nothing to stop those people, and mental health department, they don't show up there, and they don't do anything to stop those substance abusers, to stop those homeless people, and police does not do nothing to stop marijuana abuse. So Los Angeles turned into lawless city where the potholes are not being fixed, where the homeless people line up the sidewalk of downtown where the narcomafia sell dope, so, and where the property values housing are extremely expensive and practically unaffordable, housing are not being built, and where government officials like building corruptors are corrupt. And even Los Angeles Times indicated the corruption in the city of Los Angeles by citing that FBI arrested a number of Los Angeles City building corruptors, building contractors, for bribery, you know, for taking bribes from builders, you know, for building corporations and individuals, and actually. I believe that Los Angeles Times indicated also Los Angeles City Council member Juarez and Krikorian and Rosenthal in taking those tickets from the Anschutz Entertainment Group, that actually provide corrupt influence, want to bribe them and to corrupt influence against those city council members. And this we see city of Los Angeles look like when it was littered with shopping carts and tons of garbage and of Spring Street. They've never been swept, you know, because city of Los Angeles doesn't have money to sweep the city, but have money to pay egregious royalty wages, you know, to city council members, those greedy parasites and bloodsuckers who suck the last drops of blood out of the city, you know, of the city dwellers. I will city, Los Angeles, Angelina, to go to city hall and ask those city council members to stop making $178,000 a year, to cut down the weight in half, and start sweeping the floors and fixing the potholes in the city of Los Angeles. And start arresting dope dealers, you know, for illegally charging huge, egregious sums of money per 1 ounce of dope, you know, and stop dope dealing in the city of Los Angeles. So the city of Los Angeles turned into a dump, you know, and into a kind of narcotics-laden narcotic-laden heaven for illegal dope dealing and narco-mafia and corruption and quite an unlivable city. For instance, if people move to some other city like Lancaster and Antelope Valley, we find more affordable housing and than in the city of Los Angeles, which is so corrupt. And I hope that Mayor Antonio Villaraigosa is going to cut down consumer wages, right, and start sweeping the streets, Spring Street in the downtown Los Angeles, instead of banning sales of illegal dope and marijuana in the city of Los Angeles as well. Thank you so much for your attention, and hopefully you will give me your feedback by calling me on my home phone number 323-735-863, or calling my cellular number 213-448-0093. Or actually leave an email, send me an email on freeliberal, freeliberal@earthlink.net. Thank you so much for your time.